Hello, everybody. Welcome. Today we're going to be playing another game of Total War Warhammer. I'm the Strategy Professor, and this is going to be a brand new Skarsnik campaign. The DLC just got released today. I'm going to do a new Greenskins campaign for everybody. I am still going to keep up with the other Greenskins campaign that I already have going on, but I know that people want to see all the new stuff also, so I'm going to go ahead and start up a new campaign and try to run them all at the same time. It might be, you know, a couple of days before I can update each individual one, but I will keep cycling back and getting them all eventually, so hopefully you enjoy it. I'm running the same VODs, or the same mods rather, that I run with every other campaign, which is just the Diplomatic Options mod, which means that it just allows for more Confederation options, both for myself and for other people, and which usually makes for a harder, more interesting campaign, because you just get these like massive superpowers of Greenskins or Dwarves or Chaos Tribes from the North. So I think it's been a lot of fun in the other campaigns having that option out there. And I also play the Conquer Anywhere mod, so that lets me conquer any place on the map, anytime that I want. And I don't think that it makes it particularly easier for me or harder for me. I just think it's a lot more interesting. And I'm going to make my campaign goal the same as every other campaign, which is to take over the world. I want everything. I'm not just going for the very limited little whatever like objectives that it tells you. I want to kill everybody or have them bow down to me by the end of the campaign. So let's go ahead and get in here. Now, I'm not going to go over, I'm not going to go over a lot of the, like, basic stuff with Greenskins, a lot of the basic units, basic strategies, and things like that. If you want to know more insight on that, go check out my original Greenskins campaign, just the first couple of episodes. I go into a lot about what I think about the buildings, what I think about units, what I think about various strategies, basic things like that. I will talk about the new units, and I will talk about what my strategy, like, is going to be as I go forward. But it's going to be a little bit quicker than it has been in the original Greenskin campaign. Because I have a lot of returning viewers, and I don't want to spend too much time on things they've probably already seen in my other campaigns. Okay. Additional content available. Okay, cool. So it's just letting me know there's extra stuff here, which is cool. The Bloody Hands does look fun as well. The initial challenge is normal. I might go back and do the Bloody Hands one again eventually, but I do want to start off with Skarsnik. The initial challenge is hard. So what's special about this campaign? So the whole thing centers around trying to get to Carrick Eight Peaks, which is in the Badlands, the very south part of the map, like the desert area, and recapture this town down there. And you're fighting a bunch of other people to get that. So the new dwarves, when I'll do the Beligar campaign tomorrow, you'll see I'm trying to go for the same thing. I'm trying to get that same city. So you're going to be fighting, you know, dwarves to try to get there. You're going to be fighting beastmen. You're going to be fighting savage orcs down there. You're going to be fighting border princes on the way there. Like, you're going to be fighting just all kinds of crap on the way there. So it's, I did a couple of turns of this earlier just to kind of see what it's all about, just to kind of develop some strategies. And it's going to be a doozy. It's going to be tough. So that's going to be a lot of fun. Okay, so you do get extra armies with Wa, which is great. Now, as I guess it's only goblin armies with your Wa, which is a little dicey, but Underway, he has a very high chance of dodging people if he uses Underway, so you can actually use it to escape things. I have, with the other campaign, tried to bait people with Underway fighting, so I try to deliberately get them to fight me underground. So I would not want extra dodge chance, but for this, I might need it, because it's really rough early on. Like, I think you might really need to leverage those mountains and jump around early on. You'll see what I'm talking about when we get in there. So goblin focus unit with fast cavalry monsters and things like that. So you have a much more, it's limited, but it's different kind of roster. So it's going to be a very different kind of campaign from the other Greenskin campaign. So let's go ahead and get in here. Okay, so the first thing you'll notice right off the bat, this is your only choice. You must play Skarsnik, and I don't think you have access to any of the other legendary lords. So you'll never get Azog, you'll never get anyone else, any of these other legendary lords that are around. I don't think. I looked at the roster, and I don't think you can get the extra lords. So it's kind of a bummer, but at the same time, it makes it particularly challenging, so that's good. So this guy is a good melee fighter. He gets you get a goblin big boss hero. And I'm going to try to do it with the same limitations that I put on myself with the previous campaigns, where I don't assassinate lords on the campaign map, but we'll see how tough it is. If it's extremely hard, if I lose like a couple of times or something trying to, you know, make this footage, then you know, I might have to assassinate wards at least early on, just to balance it out and make it fair, because you start in an extremely, extremely difficult situation early on. So we'll see. If you're watching this episode, if this actually gets released as a VOD, not the stream, but the VOD, then you know I'm gonna make it at least through like the first 10 episodes or so, because I won't release it until I have a lot of good episodes. The people on the stream can see me fail and die a lot and, you know, enjoy that if they want, but I'm not gonna release, you know, the official VODs until I have a decent campaign going. And I have failed another campaign. Like, the first time I did Empire, when I was trying to make that footage, I died in the first 10 turns a couple of times. I did the same thing with Beastmen. So I'm not perfect. I think I'm a really good player, but I'm not perfect. And some of these things are really hard while you're learning the ropes. You're learning which strategies to use. Okay, let's go ahead and get in here. So we do start off with Squig Hoppers, which is good. I wish it was normal Squigs, but we get the Hoppers. Those are still good. We're getting Goblets of Fanatics, and we get a Ragnarok Spider, which is pretty baller. So that's awesome. And we can only recruit Goblins until we get Carrick 8 Peaks. So that's a big deal. But let's go ahead and get in here. You don't actually get a cinematic, which is kind of lame, but I know it costs a lot to make those things, and it's only $8, and you get a lot of content for $8 in this, so I can't hate on them too much. I'm gonna have to have a bite of something here while I'm talking. I haven't even stopped to eat anything all day. Run around school
from
now.
From your
this.
Redoubt in Karak Asgaraz, you have plotted your return to the Eight Peaks, stolen by filthy, perfidious greenskin rebels. The road back to the peaks will not be simple. You must head east into Empire territory. Humans have no love for greenskins, so you must fight tooth and nail to overcome them. Past the Empire, both the border princes and the dwarfs will attempt to hamper you further, but you must destroy all in your path. To the south, in Karak Izor, the foul Belagar Ironhammer has aspirations to reclaim his ancestral home. The Eight Peaks are yours, Skarsnik. Do not relent until the threat is dealt with and they are back under your control. Your enemies are belligerent and won't necessarily cow down to your indomitable will. They need to be tamed, broken, or annihilated. You have overthrown rebellions before and will do so again. All those who oppose you will face your rage, and then the hunger of Gobbler, of course. Destroy and devour all those who stand against you.
All right. As you can see, okay, it just reminds you. Now, minus 40% upkeep for all Goblin units is a huge deal. You can field some massive armies. Massive, massive armies of Goblins, so that's the good news. The bad news is you can't get any orcs, so you'll have to wait for a while. And it has this little icon, and you get negative 2 obedience because you don't have Carrick 8 Peaks. So on Legendary, that means all my towns are going to get negative 10 obedience. So I'm already sitting at negative 14, turn 1. Okay, so as you could see, just kind of an overview here. I think that Skarsnik is going to be much, much harder than the dwarves. The dwarves are also labeled as hard, and I haven't tried them yet. But we're talking about starting with goblins versus starting with, like, decked out dwarf warriors. Dwarves are much, much, much stronger in the early game than goblins are. And the dwarves also start in a much, much closer area. Like, I think they're like right here or here. Right, I think they're right here. I think that's where the dwarves start. So I have to start way up here, and dwarves start right here, and the place we're trying to race to is down here. So they get a massive head start, and there's dwarves like blocking my path to get down there. So it's a big deal. So yeah, I think it's gonna be a challenging campaign. Okay, so what's going on here? What are we gonna do? They haven't changed much with the tech tree. I'll start with that. You have to get this tech before you can get Squig Hoppers. But you can get normal Squigs without having that tech. Everything else is basically the same as it was in the original campaign, so I'm not going to go through all of that over again. Just suffice to say, the Greenskin tech is very, very underwhelming compared to most other factions. That's not really their strong suit. And you have to get any tech at all, you have to get
Supreme ruler of eight peaks.
Where's the... Oh, there's the town. So to get any tech at all, you have to get the tinker shop, which is tier 3. So that's a big deal. Oh, this looks different. Before, when I had it, like, it was all, like, jacked up looking. I don't know. Like, the interface was weird last time I logged in here, but it looks like it's normalized now. Okay, so... We need to get to... We need to get to Squigs. Squig Herd. ASAP. That's the only way we're going to tear through dwarves. Now, the other option is trolls. It's either trolls or squigs, but I think I like squigs better. Squigs are a lot cheaper, first of all. They're almost half the cost. They have similar, like, bad leadership, but because of their little, like, chomp buff that I just I talked about in my patch overview. Go check that out, by the way, if you haven't already. I released a separate patch overview. It ended up being about an hour long, which isn't awesome. You know, I didn't intend for it to take that long, but there's just a lot of stuff going on, but I'm going to put timestamps in it. But anyways, as I described there, you know, they become unbreakable at least for 15 seconds when their leadership is wavering. So I think they're going to be a bit more sturdy than trolls. We'll see. Yeah, I think my idea is to rush for squigs. It's also a cheaper building. Gonna be hard though. Going to be hard. Now, these guys are definitely what we want really fast. These nasty skulkers. So they're only tier 2. And they just have huge penetration, which I talked about once again on the preview. Huge penetration. Opportunist murder is really great. It's a lot of melee attack. And smoke bomb helps you get away from things. So I think that's pretty powerful. So we're probably gonna try to get up here and get to Squig Herd and Skulkers. Now, okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. I need this ASAP, and it's debatable here whether you go for growth to try to get to the squigs faster, or whether I would want to go for this to try to afford double armies faster, because I need two armies, like, immediately. I think I have to go for the army stuff, even though I want the growth. All right. Yeah, Wild Boy says I should definitely go for the squigs. I tend to agree.
Skarsnik!
Okay, so that's it. So we have those going. That's all good. I'll show you his skills really quick. All right, so Warlord of the Eight Peaks. He gets free lightning strike, which is amazing. But so that's great, but that doesn't fit thematically with kind of what it seems like you want to do with these guys, right? Because you get 40% reduction in cost of goblins. So I would think, you know, my first instinct would be, oh, well, then I can get three armies for basically the price of one or something like that. You know, just get a ton of extra units and then just go gang up on people, right? Use all three of my armies and just swarm them. But if you're lightning striking, you're not swarming. Like, you have to do one-on-one. You can't have any reinforcements in a lightning strike. So I'm not really sure. I guess that gives him some versatility if I want to make him into a death ball later on in the game. But it doesn't really fit thematically with what it seems like you should be doing early in the game. Okay, so he has a few different things. He doesn't ever get a mount, which I've mentioned before, and that's... It's not awesome, but... He does get his prodder, which is obedience, post-battle loot, and a lot of other good stuff. At level 8's pretty early. If we can fight and win the battle. These are okay. Now, drip and tips can be really good. That gives everyone poison attacks. So that's pretty good, but a lot of your goblins are already going to have poison attacks. But nevertheless, it could be something worth getting. Now here's where the stuff gets crazy in the middle tree. Okay, so we have intimidating presence. I was really hoping that he would do more to boost the leadership of goblins, because that's their big deal, is they're scared of a lot of stuff. So I was hoping he would have something that would shake them up and, like, keep them in line, other than just like this cooldown, which is okay, but it's kind of just putting a band-aid on a serious wound. So you get leadership and intercept. That's still not that great. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The circus has begun. So we get plus 18 melee attack for goblins and night goblin units. This is just your infantry goblin and night goblin units. This does not include Arachnarok spider units. It does not include spider riders. It does not include squig riders. It is just your base goblin units, as far as I understand. I check this and the Squig Rider did not get this bonus in my trial run where I just played a few turns earlier today. So I think it's just your flat out base infantry Night Goblin and Goblin units. It does not apply to any other variation of those units. I mean, like, Fanatics and things like that will have it, but not Squig Riders, not Spider Riders, not Wolf Riders, none of that. He still has Savages, 12% extra melee. Night Goblins have a pretty low, like, base attack, so I don't think Savages is amazing early on. It's okay, I'll get it eventually, but I don't think it's amazing early on. And then this is uninspiring. It's a little bit lazy from a design perspective, but it's interesting. It's the exact same thing, right? So plus 18, plus 20% charge, plus 18, plus 20% charge. So literally the exact same thing. So you want to go both of those. So you get plus 36 melee attack on your goblins. So that's pretty absurd. That's a lot of power for on very, very cheap units. So they're not going to be doing a ton of damage, and they're still going to have a really hard time with penetration, except for those skulkers, which are just going to have a field day with this. They're going to hit a lot. They're going to hit a lot. So that's good. Artillery is good. Now, this will give you extra, like, Squig units. Plus 12 for Squig units. So not for any other cavalry, just your Squig units. It's okay. I really wish it would say, like, all of your Goblin cavalry units or something like that. Just so it would be, you know, would include Wolves and Spider Riders and things like that. All of these are the same, basically. You get extra missile parry chance if you want up here, and wah, so that's all the same as the normal campaign. You get evasion chance plus 45% when using the underway, which is huge. It's going to let you get away from things a lot if you really need that. Then you have your standard raider, looter, or ravager. They're pretty good. Reinforcement range plus 35%. Could be pretty good. Now this is where Lightning Strike is on most trees, but here you have proper tough instead, so plus 15% campaign movement range. That's super awesome. Outcleaverins, okay. If you want to try to ambush people, I guess. The upkeep is super good, so I'll definitely get that. Even though I already have a 40% reduction, you always want to get Mob Boss. Like, it's super strong. Wild Path's okay, and that's okay. So that's it. Now, in terms of what we can hire here, you can get these guys. These guys are basically have pretty much the exact same skills that I just described there. They're super goblin specialist units, but they can get squigs. So they can ride a squig. So that makes them in some ways better than the Legendary Lord, I think. You can still get your standard, Orc Lord, and you can get your Goblin Great Shaman. I think I'm going to get a lot of these guys. For the same reason that I do in the other campaign, Sneaky Stab and Itchy Nuisance, you just have to have them. They're so powerful. So I do like the Goblin specialty stuff. That's really cool. And maybe I should go for these guys, but you're leaving so much on the table, honestly, if you don't get that. Because if you'll notice, one glaring thing that I can't build is a Shaman Hut. Can't build a Shaman Hut, because that would allow me to recruit orcs. So I'm not going to have magic for a very, very long time unless I make my lords magic users. So, and the Night Goblin Shaman's the only one that I can use, so I think I have to go Night Goblin Shamans, because it's just so powerful. So powerful. But yeah, you can't get it. Okay, so now the question becomes, hey Jawsable, good to see you, friend. Just doing a little Skarsnik campaign here. Oh, dang it, I gotta keep up with this. I don't remember when I started this. Hey, if someone could look up and tell me in the chat really quick, if you don't mind, just letting me know like how long this has been going on so far, because I really would like to keep this episode to 45 to 50 minutes, and I forgot to start my timer.
I must keep my holy vow. No!
But I'm gonna keep rolling here. Okay, so I tried running straight down and fighting Kerak Norn. That didn't work out so well in my trial. You can't siege a capital city with goblins, like, unless you, like, outnumber them 3-1 or something. They just hold you at the gate and you just can't break in. And dwarves are, like, your worst nightmare as orcs early on, so I have a few options here.
Absolutely not.
I can ignore them. and come down here. Now, there's going to be a rebellion here. That's the thing, is this province is so hard to get because it's held by dwarves. I really want Grimhold.
Skarsnik, Warlord of Eight Peaks!
I mean... So options. So I could jump over, try to fight Paravon, if I wanted to. I could go for Montefort, if I wanted to. There's a lot of stuff in here. I could go for the Secessionists. Like, one thing I had thought about is, what if I just try to, like, bum rush the Empire? Like, what if I knock out the Secessionists, grab all this crap, and then go fight Carl, but... and just make that my, like, home base of operations. I think that would be really hard to do, but I don't know of a lot of other good options. I mean, my other option is I could go down and mess with Carrick Norn, but I really think I need at least one Wall army, and maybe two, before I go down there and fight that. I could ignore him and just try to sneak down here. But I mean, this isn't a horde faction. Like, I have to be in my own territory to recruit things. Like, I can't just, like, sneak around. Like, I have to have territory when I go down there. I just can't run straight past everything and go right for Carrick Eight Peaks, I don't think. Okay, thanks, James. So James says it's been about 20 minutes, so I'll keep an eye here. Okay, so... around, like, 7:10 or something. So it's just really, really hard to figure out what to do early on. I think I'm interested in fighting and trying to gain this territory. Now, I'm not sure if I can beat up the Empire, but I know this is the wrong direction too, but I just can't. Like, I can't fight these. I mean, I guess I could go down here and try to take out Nuln. Like, so maybe I go for Helmgart, Grunsberg, and then Nuln? It's so hard to figure out how to get down there. I mean, the easiest way would just be to fight this guy. Who am I at war with?
Relations with Fun.
I think I'm only at war with Nuln or Norn. These other places don't like me, but I'm not technically at war with them, and I'm not sure if I want to shake up that hornet's nest just yet. I think I at least want to fight them to power up, to like get my Wall bar up, get a, you know, a Wall army, and then come down here and fight them. Because I need to do something, and I have to wait until I get a lot of sculptors, and I need at least 220 stacks to take that place, so I need to do something with my time. I need to fight somebody, and I think the least threatening people are going to be humans early on, because they don't have a lot of armor. And they're probably not going to have... they might have some spears. They're not going to have nearly as many spears as the Bretonians will, though. So I might be able to sneak in and use my Ragnarok effectively. So I think I have to fight humans. If I just work this backwards logically, I think I have to fight humans. And I think I have to, you know, the easiest ones are just going to be these. They're the closest and they're the weakest, I think. So,
you want
let's
schemes?
Do it.
I got schemes. I'm off.
I can scout with this guy. And once again, I'm going to try not to assassinate people with him as much as I can.
Gonna be quick.
Because if you, like, assassinate another legendary lord and then kill his army when there's nobody there, I don't know, it just feels a little dissatisfying to me.
This action does not have my consent.
Oh, did he get some new armor? Is that new splash art for him? Looks pretty cool. I mean, if I can kill Carl outside of his town, I might be like, what's Altdorf looking like? No, there's no way I'm taking Altdorf. That's crazy. Okay. Not this early. All right, let's go ahead and we'll just recruit anything we can recruit. And I'm going to go ahead and... well, my ward's just, like, the ward that I'm going to hire is just going to sit here and recruit anyways for a few turns, so I might as well not do it this turn because I'm already recruiting with this guy to power him up a little bit. What does this army look like?
Absolutely not.
Decent. But decent. What's the garrison look like? Okay, they don't have walls, though. I think I can beat this up. We'll see. Okay, don't think there's anything else I can do. To try for peace
come
with
then,
them?
Messenger. No.
I could try to buy some fights on the other side of the world if I want to. Let's see here. Who do I... Crooked... Who's Crooked Moon? Who are they at war with? Alright, good. Okay, I'm at war with... Ongrund. Also, who are people that are very far away from me? Okay, Midland. Pretty far away. They're kind of neutral with me. Talibikland. Okay, they're fighting... Skull Takers and the Beastmen, huh? Well, the Beastmen are going to go to war with me anyways, right? There's no way they're going to be friendly
with me. And then get from
so
my presence.
Let me see if they'll pay me to go to war with the Beastmen. Always check your diplomacy, especially early on. A lot of times people will pay you to go to war or they'll pay you for peace. So you're just really leaving a lot of free money on the table if you don't look. Not that much. Hopefully the Beastmen don't come, like, deliberately hunt me down, but they're gonna declare war as soon as they see me. Now, they did lower the amount that I think you can get off of this from what it used to be. Okay, cool. Got a little bit of cash. Skull Takers are a bit closer, I think. I'm not sure where they are. They're, like, around here. I don't know where the Beastmen are. They're just like in this territory. I think Skull Takers start like here. It's probably good there. What else? Who are they at war with? Nobody? Skull Takers, huh? Empire Secessionists. I could get them to help see if they'll pay me to fight the Secessionists. Since I'm gonna fight the Secessionists anyways. I'll do that next turn. I'll do it next turn. So the Secessionists don't, like, come straight for me. Okay, I think that's going to be it for this turn. Going for the old ambush. What a coward, man. I fought him on the first turn. My Empire campaign. I'm not sure, Anton. I'm gonna get a drink of water. And I'll clarify that. So... Anton asks if you can normally occupy territory that's not dwarf or orc. The answer to that is no with the traditional greenskins, but you could see, like, when they did that pan around at the beginning, it was showing you, like, walking through Empire territory. They're like, you're going to have to go through Empire, and then you have to come down and mess with the dwarves over here and the border princes and all this. So I think they do intend for you to come this way through stuff. I mean, I would do the same thing even if I couldn't occupy this territory, right? I would go fight these things to increase my WA, get 220 stacks and a WA, and then come down and fight Carrick Norn with that. You cannot run down here and fight them level 1. I tried it, and I'm bold. I do things like that in my other campaigns. I fight lots of fights that I shouldn't fight. It's impossible. Like, it takes like 4 turns to get down there. You can't even recruit for 2 of them. And you're going to be facing, like, 30 dwarves, like, with, you're going to have, like, no, like, catapults or anything, you're going to have no trolls, you're not going to have anything as good against dwarves, and they're just going to beat the crap out of you, especially on Legendary. So I'm all for, you know, bold moves, but... Now, they can occupy other stuff, too, like, the dwarves can come down here and start occupying this stuff. That happens all the time in the campaigns. We've had, like, some... really powerful dwarf factions that occupy a lot of turf. But I don't know. I don't know if they changed it for this guy or not. It seems like you would have to occupy something other than mountains as you work your way down. On Legendary, at least. I don't. Maybe not. I don't know. But I'm just running that one mod just to be consistent with my other campaigns. Okay, I'm going to go for...
I will not obey.
Gungar here. Now, I could ambush. I could also raid. I kind of want to get there next turn, though. Let's just, let's just do this. Probably move a little bit more than that. Not a lot more. That
doing one.
It's inaccurate. It was showing that. Whatever. That's fine. Let me just go ahead and go into ambush.
I like a good plan, boss.
What does this guy do? Okay, I just want him to gain some levels, so I think I'll just go ahead and deploy him here. Where'd Carl go? Carl's over here. Let me get some more intel up here. If there's any beastmen running around or anything like that. Now, obviously, they end their turn in ambush every time, but I might be able to spot them. Alright. Stupid caloric, blood feud. Blood feud's pretty good. Although you don't fight with them that much. I'm not sure if these guys get the discount or not because they're all goblins. Get the 40% discount? They might. Yeah, I think I need to go for these. I mean, the extra a lot of goblin stuff is good. I don't know, because all I can build are goblins. Let me think about this. Okay, so in theory, the magic is super powerful. And it will be later in the game when I can build orcs. But... is it better to have... now, I can get plus 12 to goblins early on. Also, I can't get the plus 36 attack damage to goblins, but my bonus will also apply to squigs. No, actually, it won't apply to squigs. Okay, so do I want plus 36 on all of my goblin fighters, plus 36 attack? Or do I want to have sneaky stab and itchy nuisance? Now later on, once I get that thing down there, I can get a bunch of goblin shamans and stuff that I can put with these guys. And maybe I do just want to go for goblins, because all I can build are goblins right now, so if it's a question of can something get plus 34 to attack for a limited window of time, or can it just always have 34 to attack through skills? I guess I have to go with always, right? Now, obviously, that's an oversimplification. Like, Itchy does extra things and Sneaky does extra things, but maybe I do, given the circumstances. I just have to go for Goblin Wars because all I can build are a lot of goblins. Both of them kind of suck, but... chance of being wounded after failure? Failure of what? He can't do anything that would cause him to fail. Well, it's better than extra upkeep, I guess. Alright, and they're really cheap. Their upkeep's super cheap. Yeah, sure. Alright, so, as you can see, same deal. Very similar. So he can get the Great Cave Squig, which is super powerful, but then all of his stuff is the exact same. So you get that extra, you know, 36 melee attack, and since all I can get are goblins, it's really good. I think Goblin Skulkers, I'm pretty sure I looked and those count. That's the big deal. If those count, that's a huge deal. Okay, so...
great and powerful war boss! Oh, I'm gonna enjoy this!
Grab three of them.
Who needs killing?
I think all of this is upgraded. Might as well. Well, do I might as well? Yeah, I guess so. It's a lot of upfront cost, but over time, it pays for itself in about 13 turns, I think. How are we looking on time? Looking okay. Alright, so we're done with that. Done with that. Can't do anything else. No one else is stepping up to us.
No.
I think we should be able to get this next turn. Oh. I can ask next turn about Helmgard. From Carl. Who detected?
Goblin's angry.
Yeah, we can take him out. How hurt is Carl?
Not likely.
He's pretty hurt.
I'll ignore
he lost that fight?
By
Ooh,
Sigma,
that's juicy.
No.
I could almost go kill Carl. That is a juicy.
Never. I refuse.
It's a juicy proposition there.
Plotting and scheming.
Do I want to take Helmgard? I could just sack it. Then I could go over and try to kill Carl
Absolutely
before anyone else.
Not.
If I was really a dirtbag, I could just assassinate Carl. I don't want to call people dirtbags that do that, but it's not my style. Now I could try to like consistently break these walls and just siege them out. Now they can come out and fight me in the field and probably destroy me with greatswords and things. I don't think I'm going to be able to get this whole province, but... I don't know.
Come, Trixie.
Alright, let me see if I can get... Carl will pay me to go to war.
Orcs, yeah, come before me! Be careful what you say, beast! Or my Reichsmarschall will have your tongue!
Alright, Carl. I just want to kill some people, man. I just want you to pay me for it. Chill. Alright. Whoa, what was that? Hold on. Oh, he would do a non-aggression. Nah, I want the money. I'm gonna get aggressive. Don't do it for free if someone will pay you for it. Some people say that about life. I think there's a time and a place for doing things for free. To help people out. Dang. Really? A high is only 50 gold these days? They've nerfed that so much. Okay. I guess we'll take what we can get. Or a moderate, I suppose, is that. So, you know, you want to buy wars, but just be careful because when you declare war on people, they might actually come and fight you. So you need to be careful who you're declaring war on.
Skarsnik.
Now this guy's going to have 12 units, I think.
What? Stick him!
I think we can probably beat him. This isn't going to be anywhere close, so I'm just going to auto-resolve it. I don't like to auto-resolve a lot of things if it's anywhere close, but this is just going to be a slaughter. See, I'm just trying to charge up this bar so that I get an extra Wa army to help me go fight those dwarves up there here in a minute. It might be best not to even take this stuff because there's just going to be random rebellions that are going to show up and cause a lot of problems also. Maybe just sacking is the way to go. I don't want to sit around and just multi-sack and level up a lot though. I think that's also potentially questionable. But it will sack it at least once. Now usually I go for Root Marcher, but this is just so like paramount for fights, like that's so powerful, you just have to get that immediately, I think. The move speed's good, but we're going to get in a lot of really, really hard fights, and I need at least this. I need at least 18. Then I can get Root Marcher, then I can work my way over to this one, but... I think this has to be our first order of business. Okay, so... You do get money for holding on to it for a couple of turns, even if someone else retakes it later.
Now. I got
spells. Yeah, let's go ahead and take it.
Escape, worthy Skarsnik.
Could put a money building here. I could also put a recruitment building here. I think I'm interested in just recruiting a lot of stuff, even if it's just little goblins. I just need like huge stacks of units.
Who needs killing?
I think that's what I have to do. I do want the money, but I just want like one extra place so I can recruit with both groups at once. So I can recruit with him.
Trixie. Ready for bossing! Moving out!
I love the green skins. They're so much fun. They're so funny. Alright, these guys are a lot more expensive, but... I think, have a couple of these. These are pretty good against Empire. They don't have heavy armor. I could go for Montefort. I could start going over there if I wanted to. I don't want to shake up too much of a hornet's nest. You have to be really careful in this region. I learned that with Empire the hard way a couple of times. You don't want to, like,
do
make
not
everyone
take
mad.
Me for a fool.
But you want to make a couple people mad. Okay, so
yes, I'm a schemer.
I'm going to go ahead and combine him over here because he's a decent fighter. That should make sure I can win this. Because I do have an Arachnarok Spider. I mean, that's a big deal.
Sigma.
And this guy just has, like, you know, little whatever units. Oh, I took his recruitment building, so that stopped him from recruiting. That's even better. Nice.
I'll ignore that.
God. Double recruitment.
I will not obey.
Right, it's about to get crazy. It's about to go down.
What?
So I need to get to 17 units, like, immediately. Is there anything else that I want money from right now? I don't think so.
You dare!
I think it's good. Alright. Oh. How much? 520. 40 a turn and 10 growth, huh? To take 12 turns to pay for itself. I could very well get a rebellion where I'm going to lose it anyways. I think I'll pass. Secessionists are calling in the fringe.
Who can I stand? Goblins angry.
Do you take me for a wazzock?
Oh my god.
No, I will not shame my clan.
Things are about to get real, really fast.
Ugh, the greens.
Skarsnik, warlord of eight peaks.
Yeah, so he might come down here and take me.
You want schemes? I got schemes.
So 9. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 on...
You need me!
11. have an Arachnarok. I have a Legendary Lord. And also have goblins.
Not likely.
I don't think he had anything that
I got
crazy.
Fans.
Okay, Carl did get this on the second attempt. Now I could come over here and knock out Carl. I could pin him in there. And then this guy's gonna take this back.
I got me brother.
These guys are just waiting to jump over this wall. I can't beat that. Not with one army.
Skarsnik!
Now, if I win like two extra fights, I might be able to do some things.
Night Gobbo War Boss!
I could creep over here.
You need help!
I don't know, it's a gamble coming over here to try to mess with the Empire right now. I think this is a surefire, and I do want to, like, do a fight this episode, so. It's dangerous. It's gonna be tough. I think we can do it, though. We might get pretty beaten up. Uh-oh. I think we can still do it. I'm not at war with those other people yet. Lightning Strike's not gonna help, I don't think. No. Spearmen. I think so. I think we can just hold the line with these guys. Unbreakable. Yeah, let's do it. Let's get a good fight going here. If you've never watched any of my campaigns before, I always try to do at least one good fight per episode if I can, and I like to keep the episodes to be around, you know, 50 minutes to an hour or so. Some of them get much longer than that. Like, you know, I've had episodes as long as an hour and a half. If we just have, like, really crazy fights that just last a long time, or if I just lose track of time or something.
Ready to scrap!
That's what some of these people look like. They look pretty cool. I'll show you. Those Swoop Riders. It's fun. Sweet. Okay. Alright, so that just speeds people up and gives a lot of leadership. Now, he also. No, he can't ambush or hide or whatever. Which would make more interesting if he, like, Trixie, whatever. Trixie traps. It would be nice if he could, like, Vanguard also, but he can't. They don't have cavalry or anything. Okay, these can vanguard. I don't think it's really worth it. They can't hide. Now these guys can skulk though. I do think that putting these guys like right here might be a good deal. It'd be nice if I could just skulk around with these guys.
I'm the boss! Drink the brew!
So I'll call this my two group.
Goblins.
Three group. I guess I can just micro those guys in and out, it's fine.
You first.
Now, I don't do beautiful little, you know, images or whatever. I'm just very practical. I know some people are they've said they're very OCD and they wish I would, like, you know, make my formations in these, like, beautiful lines and things like that. I'm not really all about that. I'm more just about the practicality of it and just adjusting sort of mid-fight with what's going on. They're gonna make me come to them. So I'm not gonna be able to use the goblins kind of the way that I want. Where do I want these, Yeah, I want to send these into kind of these tight rotations here. I kind of want to get a feel, since this is pretty low risk, just how long it takes before they're spotted while they're in Skulk. See like what the range is on that, so they still can't see him. For real? They haven't been spotted yet? Dang. Now, with the Fanatics, I really don't want to flank. Like, I don't want the Fanatics, like butchering into my own lines, right? I don't think they're spotted. Jeez, grab these two. Let's get those up there.
Moving fast.
Don't want to get too close.
The brother's ready. Mr. King. Goblins.
So I want these going up here first. I have to flank the spider around. Let's not go in there yet. Hold on. I need the silver shield up there first. They can absorb shots. Jesus. Come on, run back. They count. Why aren't they firing earlier? Are they just holding fire? They're chasing.
You first. Good plan.
That's good. Okay, that's fine.
What are we doing? Gonna kill him.
They want to fire onto my silver shields. It's fine. All right, let's go ahead and fire on them. Oh dang, that does a lot of damage, nice. Yeah, it felt like it did like a decent amount of damage. I need to wait for them to commit. There we go. Now we've got some proper stuff. Get over there with the swigs.
Moving fast. Running. Get scrap. Warlord of eight pace. Get that to ready. Yeah.
Let's go right here. It's fine. Alright, Squigs have those guys done. Let's get over here. That looks good. Yeah, I can face tank with him. Where's my goblin guy? He's in there fighting. That's good. Nice. They're done. Let's go shoot at these guys. Alright, whatever. They're running away. Well, no, they're not. Get them. Should have these guys done over here. Oh no, not their ward. Get out. Running. Come over here, get this ward. Get this ward right here, get that guy.
Warlord of Eight Pates! Goblins! Please, goblins!
Right there. Warlord Spider on the ward, that's what I want. What? These like little warlord dude. The Free Company are just beating up my Squig Riders. What? Tier 1 beating up tier 3? What? Yo, get that guy right there. That one. Alright, go ahead and fire that over there. Go ahead and flank this. Wait, where's the ward? Oh, the ward ran. Get the ward, get the ward. They're dead. Get over here. Go kill these guys.
Moving fast. Warlord of Eight Pates. Running. Yes, they're doing it. Running. We're all moving fast. House.
What the?
Running. Walks win. Goblins rule! Attack!
They're coming!
Get that guy. Get that guy. Like, why is it attacking anything other than this guy? Like, I'm saying to attack this guy right here. Run, get out of there.
God.
For real, like, why is it not attacking the thing that I'm telling it to attack? Quit attacking those little peasants and get their ward. Maybe they're just microing it a lot better. Maybe the AI did get a lot better about microing. I don't know. If they kill him, it's probably over anyways. I'm gonna have to retry it, I guess, which sucks. But I tried to take on something challenging early on, but apparently their AI has gotten tremendously better. In terms of the micro, or my spider just doesn't know how to like actually hit the targets that I'm telling it to hit. We can still win if we can kill this guy.
Kick up.
but we have to actually, like, hit the correct person.
Who killed another? This better work! Shifting it! Running!
Charge him. Boom. Okay, hit him. Hit the actual person that I'm telling you to hit. Not those guys, this guy right here. Kill him, kill him, kill him, kill him. Okay, got him. We got the Lord. Get the range units. Okay, got him. Where is he? I need to kill as many of these running units as I can that are free, because the more units that you kill, the more likely they are to run. That everyone else is going to run. How much health does he have? 143. Oh, we're gonna have to cause terror here. Nope. Not this guy. There we go. Spider first. Spider has a lot of armor. I just need to... Oh, these guys are gonna slaughter me. I love it how they're just like totally rallying back, no problem. With their lord dead, my lord's alive. Kill a bunch of them. I think these two can, like, two-man, like, run this. Like, the only thing that's a threat is the range units. So if I can just run over here and get closer to these guys who are winning fights, then I might be able to hold. I really need this cooldown to finish. Okay, they're done. How are they rallying back? I need to get over here and get close to these other things. Run.
I'm the boss! Seven!
Holy crap. Alright. Welcome to the Skarsnik campaign, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, the campaign was pretty smart the way they were microing that general in and out. Now they're all gonna die here. I'm gonna speed it up. They're all gonna die here because they're in the town, but I just want to kill as many as possible just to get that extra little bit of gold that you get for capturing and killing people at the end. Just want to try to get some of those kills here. Yeah, flawless victory. Just basically lost the campaign the first episode almost. I mean, we could definitely come back from it, but It's not good. It's not good. I mean, I did walk into like a 10 on 16 against legendary stat AI, which you don't know how important those legendary stats are. Watch my dwarf number 11 video from the original campaign that I did with the dwarves. I explain quite a lot of that. Yeah, I think you're right, Yamo. The reason that I put things on defend like that is to try to get them out of combat. But maybe it's messing with their AI when they're actually in the fight. Almost want Skarsnik to die so that I can get him back full health in 5 turns. I don't want to lose my whole army for it. I wish you could just, like, sub them out, like, sub someone else in and then sub the other person out for, like, 5 turns. And then they healed back to full after 5 turns or something. So that you could keep... you know, keep going. But we're gonna have to wait. Did I not? Oh, I did. Oh, I did have it on somebody, but my fanatics died. That's a shame. Spider killed 429 people. The next closest is probably Skarsnik with 89. Actually, this killed 95. Oh, those killed almost 200. Wow. Killed a lot more than I thought they did. Yeah, I can't believe that these Free Company Militia were able to beat up my Squid Coppers, like, straight up. One-on-one combat. Basically, that's what happened. I should have just kept the Squid Coppers just flanking and attacking the normal infantry, but I'd have something to tie these things up. Those things are tough. Yeah, so I deployed less than them. Their units are all... like, tougher than mine, individually. Like, the swordsmen are better than goblins, normally, and they have crazy legendary stats. But I managed to pull it off. I think we really need the replenishment, honestly. I mean, we need money, clearly, but... replenishment's kind of a big deal, too. Now, I'm not sure if I'm gonna have enough, left in the tank to occupy this. Enough movement left, and if I don't, then these guys are going to take it, probably. So I need to just go ahead and occupy, I think, and then try to get peace with these guys. I think I can occupy this. No, Yamo, that's literally the kills from that last battle. That's not total, like, over a lifetime. That's just that last battle. So that spider literally killed 430 things in that last battle. No, it's literally, it killed 429 things in that battle. Like, that's, yeah, it killed a quarter of their army by itself. That's the most I've ever seen by a single unit. It was the only one that was man enough or woman enough or spiderly enough or whatever. To it gives birth to little spiders, so I guess it's a woman. I've always thought it was a woman. So the Greenskins do have females on their roster. Yeah, the Arachnorok spider is my favorite unit as the Greenskins. It's pretty close.
Lots of plans.
All right, well, what do we win? Nothing. I think we have to really consider going for this casualty replenishment at this point. I mean, I would love to go for the money, but... I mean, how much extra is 2%?
I'm a schemer!
That's a pretty good chunk. I mean, we got 4% for occupying this. I think I definitely have to hire these. I don't even care what they are. I just need to hire them in case someone attacks me next turn. These guys attack me? Who are these? Skull smashes, huh? Oh, they're probably chill with me. Yeah, they're chill. Y'all want a confederate or something?
What do you get, one?
Okay, sweet. Well, we got that settled, so I'm not gonna die next turn, hopefully. mean, I guess Marienburg could come at me. Unless the beastmen just pop up out of nowhere and kill me next turn. Totally possible. I mean, I could.
What do you geeks want?
In theory, confederate with them? Even though they're kind of they aren't tribal. They have a town. We're on time. Are we way over? Yeah, we're way over on time. Okay, let me finish up this turn, and then that'll end the episode, and then I might be able to do one or two more. I'll take a short break, though. My wife came home, so I might take a 5-minute break. Let's go ask her how her day was or whatever. Yeah, we gotta get this immediately. And we need to hire, just max out the credit card goblins. We probably need to go for... Thinking, well, that wasn't even worth it. Like, I won battle, and then I lost 18 for casualties, so I didn't get anything off of that, any fightiness. These guys are just gonna kill me here in a second. I might need to go for Dirty Skulk. Oh, I can't go for the Skulkers, because I don't have enough growth. I think I have to do shiny stuff. I need money.
Who can I stab?
Yeah, if those dwarves come over, I'm gonna have to have a lot of these guys for those dwarves. As long as I'm hiring every turn, I think we're all good. I think that's it. Yeah, looks at diplomacy. I don't think anyone else. I could try to get peace with these.
Kazak back super quick.
They don't like me. It's gonna be a minute before I can negotiate that. Y'all had enough yet?
A green skin.
No, they have not. They're so much stronger
you
than me.
You have seconds to live.
It's probably not even funny. Empire is still very weak.
I will hear your petition, but make no promises to act on it.
I want to take
Orcs
them out. Really
come
can.
Before me with a.
Just looking and see who all these people are fighting. Okay, I think that's fine. Alright, we go ahead and end the turn, and then we'll see what happens, and we'll end the episode. Yeah, I'm not gonna care that. Oh, he's raiding me now. Even though
your prestige grows, my lord. News of your conquest spreads far and wide. Your develop.
Whatever, I guess.
I'm Trixie.
Yeah, I'm replenishing a little bit here. Oh, I didn't hire these two dudes. I needed to do that last turn. These are kind of like mercenaries from past Total War games, but you have to level up to be able to unlock different ones. Oh, dang. When I get to level 5, I get Squig Hoppers? That's pretty sweet. Without having to have the tech for them. And then after they die, I think you can hire them back after a little while. I'm not 100% sure. I haven't actually played a campaign with any units of renown yet, so... we'll level that guy up in a little bit. We'll get him a giant wolf. But anyways, if you're just here for the VOD, thank you very much for tuning in. Hopefully you enjoyed it. We had an awesome, really close fight this episode. Just a little preview to see just how tough this is going to be. You know, anytime you're fighting goblins against, you know, real units, it's a hard time. But, you know, once I start getting these extra modifiers, then, you know, we might be able to put a dent in them. We'll see. But you definitely have to have those goblin modifiers, I think. It was the right call not to go for the sneaky stab and stuff. Oh, jeez.
Big arm.
Well, our day of reckoning is coming. They are about to come kill us. So we're gonna have to run over here and tag team this guy. Now, if we can take him out,
do you take me for a wazzock?
There's a possibility that we could take this stronghold out, but he's almost certainly gonna kill my town in like two or three turns. So we'll see you next time. But thank you very much. That's gonna be it for this video. If you enjoyed this, please check out the rest of the content on the channel. We do have another Greenskins campaign, the original one when the game came out. It's still going on. It's been a great, glorious campaign so far, so stay tuned for that. We also have everything except for Chaos so far, and I'm about to start the new Dwarf content campaign tomorrow as well. We also have I'm going to be playing some more multiplayer. Hopefully they fix some of the imbalances. We'll see. I talked about that in a separate video. Sort of my thoughts on the new balance patch, so check that out on the channel. And then I'm going to eventually do some more XCOM 2. I started doing a series on that, but I haven't really followed up with it that much. I've been super busy with school and other things. And then I have a series with League of Legends where I'm trying to get to Diamond but only playing support. And the season's coming up in a couple of weeks. I'm trying to make my last push to get there. And then Civ 6 comes out either late tonight or tomorrow. And as soon as that does, I'm definitely going to play a lot of Civ 6 as well. So it's going to be a lot of Warhammer, a lot of Civ 6 over the next couple of days. So be sure to stay tuned and check that out. Of course, I guess by the time this airs, it probably will not be those days, right? Because I'm going to make sure that I have at least 10 quality episodes before I release them. But there should be a lot of content. That's the bottom line. Check it out. A lot of great stuff on this channel. And be sure to leave me some comments. If you're interested in anything, or you want to see me try something, or you just want my thoughts on something, just let me know. I answer every comment. I'm usually very pleasant. I like to think of myself as very informative and welcoming. So leave me your comments. I'm more than happy. We're building a great community here. And everyone's having a lot of fun, so feel free to chip in anytime. This was also live streamed, as I said before, so be sure to tune in for some of the live streams. I don't have a definite schedule just because my work and personal schedule is kind of crazy these days. But in general, I do get on at least some in the evenings and some in the mornings a lot of the times. If you ever miss it, you can always go back and watch a VOD of the complete streams if you want to check those out as well. And then I turn them into individual episodes just like this if you just want those episodes. So that's going to be it. Thank you very much, and I'll see you next time. Have a wonderful evening.